I am Drishya MK, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics and Communication, Jyothi Engineering College, Thrissur. Today I am going to discuss the topic FM microwave radio repeaters. So the permissible distance between FM microwave transmitter and a receiver depends on several factors such as transmitter output power, terrain, atmospheric condition, system capacity, etc. So typically this distance is between 15 miles and 40 miles. So with systems that are longer than 40 miles or when geographical obstructions such as mountains, lakes block the transmission path, repeaters are needed. So a microwave repeater is a transmitter and receiver placed back to back with the system. The repeater station receives signals, amplifies and reshapes it and then retransmits the signal to the next repeater or terminal station. So this is the block diagram for a microwave repeater. You can see in between microwave transmitter and receiver, repeaters are placed. Now the types of microwave repeater. Basically there are three types of microwave repeaters: IF, intermediate frequency microwave repeaters, baseband microwave repeaters, and RF, radio frequency microwave repeaters. So first is intermediate frequency microwave repeater. So with this with an IF repeater, the received RF carrier is down converted to an intermediate frequency. It is then amplified, reshaped and up converted to RF frequency and then transmitted. That is, the signal is never demodulated below IF. Consequently, the baseband intelligence is unmodified by the repeater. So this is the block diagram. Here you can see the receive antenna will receive the RF signal and it is then down converted to IF and it is then amplified and reshaped and it is then up converted and then fed to transmit antenna. Now baseband repeaters. With a baseband repeater, the received RF carrier is down converted to an IF frequency, amplified, filtered and then demodulated to baseband. So the baseband signal, which is typically frequency division multiplexed voice band channels, is further demodulated to a master group or even channel level. So this allows the baseband signal to be reconfigured to meet the routing needs of the overall communication network. So once the baseband signal has been reconfigured, it FM modulates an IF carrier, which is up converted to an RF carrier and then retransmitted. So you can see the block diagram here. The RF signal is down converted to IF, it is then down converted to baseband. In the next section, this intermediate to RF, it is then fed to transmit antenna. One more baseband repeater configuration is this. Here, the repeater demodulates the RF to baseband. It is then amplifies and reshapes and then modulates the FM carrier. So with this technique, a baseband is not reconfigured. So you can see, okay, so essentially this configuration accomplishes the same thing that an IF repeater accomplishes. That is, the difference is that in a baseband configuration, the amplifier and equalizer act on baseband frequencies rather than intermediate frequencies. So the baseband frequencies are generally less than 9 MHz, whereas the intermediate frequencies are in the range 60 MHz to 80 MHz. So consequently, the filter and amplifiers necessary for baseband repeaters are simpler to design and less expensive than the one required for IF repeaters. So here the disadvantage is that the addition of FM terminal equipment. Next is RF repeaters. So with this RF to RF repeater, the received microwave signal is not down converted to either IF or baseband. It is simply mixed with a local oscillator frequency in a nonlinear mixer. You can see here block diagram. So the output of mixer is tuned to either the sum or the difference between the incoming RF and the local oscillator frequency, depending on whether the frequency up or down conversion is desired. The local oscillator is sometimes called a shift oscillator and is considerably lower in frequency than either received or transmitted radio frequencies. Here you can see, for example, incoming RF of 16.2 GHz is mixed with a 0.2 GHz local oscillator frequency, producing sum and different frequencies of 6.4 GHz and 6 GHz. So for frequency up conversion, the output of the mixer would be tuned to 6.4 GHz, and for down conversion, the output of the mixer would be tuned to 6 GHz. So here now it will not down converted to either IF frequency or baseband frequency. So reconfiguring and reshaping are not possible with RF to RF repeaters. So that's all about microwave radio repeaters. Thank you.